words in my heart, that I may not sin against God.
So one day he boarded a ship that was bound for America, and he ended up making his way to the city of Philadelphia. And there he opened a print shop, and people would come to him and get flyers made and posters, you know, things like that, you know, kind of like we do today, you know, lost wife, lost dog, lost canoe, reward for canoe, okay? You know, things like that. And they called them back then, Brother Bill, what did they call those posters? They called them broadsides is what they called them. And that was how they got their news out at that time, okay? They didn't have fake news. I mean, honestly, when they said the British were coming, the British were coming, okay? There was no fake news back then, okay? So, you know, but we had these broadsides that would be tacked up in various places around the town for people to read to find out what was going on. And one day a man came into the shop with a handwritten document, and he asked John to print up 200 copies. And it took quite a while for him to get this put together because, you know, back in those days, you had to set it by hand, each letter, okay? But when John was done with the job, those broadsides were taken by riders to different cities all the way from Massachusetts down to Georgia. And the date was July the 4th, 1776, and the man who placed the order was none other than John Hancock. And the document was the Declaration of Independence. So more than anyone else, John Dunlap was responsible for spreading the word that America was now free. You know, and as Christians, we have to spread the word too. We have to tell the world about a better freedom, freedom from penalty of sin, and it's called the Great Commission. And in Matthew 28, verse 19, Jesus said, go. He didn't say, think about it. He didn't say, ponder on it. He said, go. and make disciples of all nations. In other words, we should spread the word to everyone that Jesus has set us free. So y'all remember that during all of our festivities today and over the today and tomorrow for the 4th of July. Jesus has set us free, okay? And we need to tell everyone about that. Y'all have a good day.
Thanks, Brother Calvin. Man, y'all like that video at the beginning? It still gives me chills. I mean, I saw that video for the first time like 20 years ago. And still, every time I watch it, and especially as a history teacher, just gets me. It just gets me because, you know, our founding fathers did believe in God. They intended on Him to be a part of our country. And, you know, as we studied this morning at Sunday school about being complacent, we got to quit being complacent or all of our freedoms are going to be taken away from us. And we've got to insist that God is still a part of our country today. And we've got to get our country turned back and focused toward Him. Today, I love it when holidays fall on Sunday. My favorite's Christmas on Sunday. But 4th of July, this is maybe one of the first 4th of Julys I remember on a Sunday. I'm sure there have been many. I just didn't think of it that way. But we can thank God today that we are free. And we can thank Him because of all the men and women who have served, who have made that possible for us, and still make it possible for us today. So let's sing with all our hearts, thank God I'm free. Freedom from sin is the best freedom we could ever want to have. Jesus Christ, dying on the cross for us, resurrected again, washing all of our sins away. And like we learned in our Sunday school lesson, once our name is written in that book of life, it can never be erased. Let's stand as we continue singing. This is how it feels to be free.